Good afternoon. My name is Dr. Bridget Brennan. I'm the Chief Medical Officer for the Benefis Medical Group and an emergency physician by training. I'm here today to talk a little bit about COVID-19 and the upcoming flu season and to answer some of your questions. So both COVID-19 and influenza are caused by viruses. They're different viruses and they have a lot of the same symptoms, so sometimes it's very hard to tell the difference between the two. The seasonal flu virus is usually caused by influenza A or B. Those strains change over time, and so that is what the virus or the vaccine is based on. The COVID-19 virus is a new coronavirus. Just emerged last winter, about this time actually, and that is what has been responsible for this pandemic the last year. COVID-19 seems to be a little bit more contagious than influenza. The symptoms usually take a little longer to develop, and it typically lasts a little bit longer than the flu, and certainly can cause much more severe illness in some people. The most common symptoms between both COVID and influenza are fever, chills, headache, usually a cough, body pain and muscle aches, and fatigue. Sometimes in kids, you'll see a little more nausea and vomiting in both COVID and the flu, and then diarrhea as well. Some of the more unique symptoms to COVID, and one probably everybody is familiar with right now, is the loss of your sense of smell and taste. You see more of a runny nose sometimes with COVID, and then again, the much more severe illness that results in hospitalization and a lot of times death in some certain populations. We can tell the difference between the two using a nasal swab or a nasopharyngeal swab. It's a much deeper swab, and they can test for both the COVID-19 virus and the influenza virus. The treatment for most people is actually pretty similar. It's symptomatic, which means we ask people to rest and make sure you're drinking plenty of fluids. You can take Tylenol or ibuprofen for any body aches or pain you might be having, or for fever. The most important things I want you to know is that the way to avoid both of these is the same: good hand washing, covering your nose and your mouth when you cough or sneeze, staying away from other people when you're sick, and when you're out and about, wearing a face mask. That protects you from me, and if you have one, it protects me from you. Right now, the first doses of the COVID vaccine are just coming out. The numbers are fairly limited, and the goal is to have our frontline healthcare workers and our residents in our long-term care facilities vaccinated first. These are the most high-risk people in the population right now. As more and more vaccine becomes available, it will be open to the general population or the public. And right now, it's not real clear who's going to be able to vaccinate from their office. One of the vaccines, the Pfizer vaccine, actually requires ultra cold storage, which means you have to have a freezer that goes down to minus 80 or below. And most people don't have that in their offices. And so that will likely be restricted to the bigger hospitals and systems that have that capability. The other vaccines don't require that ultra cold storage and will likely be what is distributed to the health departments and to the long-term care facilities, and likely to your doctor's offices later. Because we just don't know, I don't have any details as to who will have availability first. We're just gonna have to kind of wait and see what comes out in the media. Yes, again, it will be the different vaccines, the Moderna vaccine, and probably the ones that are following that. They don't require the storage at the low temperatures, and they can be shipped in smaller batches. So those will go out to the critical access hospitals and to the smaller communities. And it'll be up to the local authorities as to who distributes those. I would imagine the health departments in the communities will probably be the first line. So again, more details to follow as soon as those are released and approved for use. They'll likely be shipped out probably the beginning of the year into spring and summer of 2021. Both vaccines right now that are out do require a second dose. If you get the first dose, you'll probably be given a second, you'll be given a little reminder card that will tell you when you need to come back. And in some instances, the day you get your first dose, you'll probably be scheduled for the second. It has to be given in a certain amount of time. So where you get your vaccine will help you get that second dose scheduled. There's quite a few options for that. If you have severe underlying health concerns, you are diabetic or you have chronic heart or lung disease, the earlier you're tested, the earlier we'll get your results back. And then there are some treatment options provided you find out within a certain amount of time. And so you can call your physician's office. Some will actually have you come in, but you need to let them know ahead of time that you have symptoms. Others might suggest you go to one of the clinics. The Alluvian Clinic is doing a drive-through testing station. Our walk-in clinic here and our Northwest Clinic can do testing. Those tests get sent to the state lab, and they usually take at least a couple of days to get back. So the earlier you get tested in your illness, the faster we'll get those results. And if you qualify for certain treatments like our monoclonal antibody infusion, we can get you in and get you treated and hopefully prevent you getting very ill or ending up in the hospital. If you are feeling very short of breath or severely ill, you can't get up and walk, or you're just too weak, then I would suggest calling 911 and coming into the emergency department. We can test you there as well and get you taken care of. Any vaccine has the potential to cause some side effects. The most common ones I'm hearing about as far as the COVID vaccine are pain at the injection site. Some people get some mild body aches, maybe some chills. Small number might have a fever. As with any vaccine or any medication, there's always a chance for an allergic reaction, at which point the provider or the healthcare facility where you're getting your vaccine will be able to take care of that. For people who have already had COVID, you will have some natural immunity for at least a few months after you've been ill. Most people think that it lasts up to 3 months and probably longer. It hasn't been around long enough for us to do any long-term studies, but we're recommending actually that you wait at least 90 days after you've had COVID to get the vaccine. Again, the most important things you can do are ones I've already talked about and what you've been hearing for months and months and months. Wash your hands. Cover your mouth and nose if you're sick or you're sneezing and coughing. Stay away from other people. If you go out, wear a mask. If you are feeling, severely ill, please go see your doctor or seek medical attention so that we can get you taken care of. Thanks for your time today and all of your questions, and stay well.